The mathematical model consists of governing equations defined in a domain and boundary conditions defined at the edges of the domain. We already specified the domain in the geometry step. Here we'll specify the governing equations and then we will specify the boundary conditions. If I go to one of my pre-analysis slides, we can remind ourselves what the governing equations are. They are the differential equations of equilibrium for 2D with no body forces, and then to write these equations in terms of the displacements and to close the equation set, we have to bring in the stress-strain relations and the strain-displacement relations. If I go to the project page, okay, now we set the analysis system to static structural and the analysis type to 2D. It turns out ANSYS uses both these clues, and it turns on this. It's already turned on these equations with zero, with no body forces. So this is turned on, and it's to write this in terms of the displacements. It's turned on the stress-strain relations and the strain-displacement relations. In fact, it's turned on the the 2D plane stress version of the Hooke's law, and we can see that if I go to the mechanical window, and if I highlight geometry, I see the 2D behavior is set to plane stress, and that's the plane stress version of Hooke's law. Okay, so that's turned on, but it doesn't have the right value of E and nu, and it gets that from the material assignments. If I go to under geometry to the surface, the assignment is structural steel, so we need to change that. So it has the right equations, it doesn't have the right constants in the equations. And then it has also turned on the strain displacement relations. So the only thing we need to do to specify the governing equations are to specify E, the Young's modulus, and nu, the Poisson's ratio. Let's do that. I need to go to the project page, and let me move this to the right. And I'll right-click on engineering data, and I'll say edit. And I'll create a new material. Okay, I'll click over here and I'll call the material A514 steel and enter. Okay, so it has this material, but we have to give it inputs and drag isotropic elasticity onto the material. I believe you can also double-click. And we want to set the Young's modulus in PSI. So I will set the unit here, and the value we are given is 29, 10 to the power of 6, or e to the power of 6. And then if I come over here, the Poisson's ratio is 0.3. Okay, now that's only created the material. It hasn't assigned it to the model yet, so we have to go do that. That's easy to forget. So I have to go to the project page and I'll right-click on model and say refresh. Okay, and you see this is the refresh sign. It goes away from the model, so the changes from the engineering data have propagated to the model. And now if I go to the model, and I can under geometry, the surface, I can change the assignment to A514 steel. And that essentially gives it the right E, the Young's modulus and Poisson's ratio in the stress-strain relations. That's all there is to specifying the governing equations. And I'll say File, Save Project.